What happens when a little girl from a small village grows up to be not a fairy godmother, but a compassionate hand to millions? This is the journey of a big life, told in little stories. Sudha Murty looks like your favorite grandma. But that's just her disguise. She is a superwoman. Mrs. Murty is brave and strong, and she fights for everyone. She was the only girl in her batch at her engineering college, and the first woman engineer in her office. She and her team of heroes are doing so many things to help people whom no one else is helping. They save old monuments, build schools and hospitals, and help people become stronger in the world. She's curious, loves books, and has built libraries. So many libraries. Mrs. Murty says she learns the most from people. She loves traveling and knows people all over the country. Some call her Akka, some call her Amma, some call her Didi, and some Aji. They have had many adventures, and Mrs. Murty loves to tell their stories in her books. So many adventures, so many stories. In a land close by, lived the Devdasis. The Devdasis were troubled, and no one listened to them or cared about them. Mrs. Murty decided to help them, but she didn't know it was going to be so difficult.
There is an epicenter where Devdasis, which was once upon a time a very artistic people, would be giving their life to Lord and serve Him. Now, over a period of time, they became sex workers now in today's scenario. So without anything, I just made a decision that I should help them. I went and met them with a pen and a pen and a pad. And I used to wear in those days jeans and a t-shirt. I had a bobbed hair. And they said, go back. We don't want to tell about our life. We don't want to listen to you. And I insisted, you know, that please listen to me. Then they threw chappals at me. I came back home and I cried for some time and I kept quiet. And after 2 weeks or 3 weeks, so I went back again. This time, so they were separating the bad tomato, rotten tomato, and good tomato. And again, I went and reiterated the same thing. I come again, and they said, you don't have any brain. We don't want to talk to you. They threw tomatoes at me, rotten tomatoes. And this time, I felt, why should I work? You know, I want to help them. I want to spend my time. I want to give my best, and the receiver is not ready. Then, you know, my father came. My father was a doctor. He said, if you want to be with them, then you should become a lady next door. Think over it, change your dress code. Become very simple lady next door. Then I wore a Mangalsutra, tied my hair, then wore a sari, then took my father and went to that place. My father said, my daughter is a school teacher and she would like to help your children's education. And I was taken aback. I wanted to tell them, look, there is AIDS, and my father is saying, my daughter is helping them. I told my father in a different language, you know, that I didn't start with that. I have come for something. He said, being a mother, you should understand the best way to approach a mother is always through her children.
Ma,
or
बच्चे के बीच
में बीच के स्कूल में कितने जन पूछते माँ का नाम पापा का नाम लिखाते ना मतलब देदासी लोग नहीं लिखते मतलब माँ का नाम लिखाते थे जुड़वाते इसलिए मेरे को पापा कहाँ है बोल के
दस माई फ्रेंडशिप विद देम स्टार्टेड विदाउट टॉकिंग अबाउट एड्स विदाउट टॉकिंग अबाउट डिसीज विदाउट टॉकिंग अबाउट हेल्प द ओनली थिंग आई विल डू इज आई विल यूज स्कॉलरशिप टू अवर चिल्ड्रन सो दैट दे कैन कंप्लीट देयर एजुकेशन एंड आफ्टर 20 ईयर्स देयर चिल्ड्रन गॉट एम्प्लॉयड एज अ पुलिस कॉन्स्टेबल टीचर नर्सिस some stable jobs. I would not have done this work really this well without the support of Abhay Kumar, an engineer from Delhi. He had learned Kannada. He started eating Jawar roti and he came with a new bright ideas. Abhay stayed and is staying in Raichur even today.
I am now in Raichur since 18 years. Before that, I was like any other young engineer working in a multinational in Bangalore. And these 18 years of work along with a beautiful team and the motherly figure of Mrs. Sudha Murty behind us actually is what is responsible for whatever we have been able to do today.
We had a lot of difficulties, actually. It is a toughest work. Pimps will call us. You get down the Raichur station, we'll break your knee. They'll call Abhay, you know, we'll throw acid on you. And Abhay would tell, ma'am, even though I die, it doesn't matter if I can save four girls.
Devadasar andra namanna ganmakalu 20 rupay kodti ba 10 rupay kodti ba anta karitidru namu namaga kashta bartutta avaga
to mai to devadasi hu fir bhi mere bachche log education continue hua nahi to education stop ho jata tha abhi education continue karke abhi ek kaam par lage government job mila hai
so many lives getting changed. We feel very proud when we see somebody completing their masters or completing their nursing and things like that.
Sudha Murty madam scholarship dete the bachon ke liye notebook pen kuch paise bhi dete the
12,000 people have got scholarship up to this day. It was bit by bit, epsilon by epsilon in a mathematical term, I can tell you. Over a period of time, you know, we could change 3,000 of them. And then they wanted to honor me. They called me as Akka. Akka means in Kannada language, sister. I always thought with money and sincere work, you can achieve anything. That is not true. It is not only sincerity, you have to make the entire community aware of what they are undergoing. There is an alternate way of living and there are many people who would like to help them.
Mrs. Murty is happiest when she's learning something new. She found that books are like windows into other worlds. So she started collecting all the books she could find. And she began setting up libraries. So many libraries.
I met her sometime in 1974. A friend of mine, he used to borrow books from me. He would be sitting next to Sudha, I believe, on the bus going to Pimpri Chinchwad. On the book, one day it would be there, Narayan Murty, Istanbul. Second day, another book, Narayan Murty, Prague. Third day would be Narayan Murty, Warsaw, etc. So I believe one day Sudha asked him, who is this international bus conductor who is going from place to place to place? And that is when Mr. Prasanna said, why don't you meet this international bus conductor? That's how I met her the first time.
My mother has a library, my father has his, and I have mine. But in general, yes, my mother is very strict about her library. It's very well organized. I think my father's too. Books have been sort of the way of creating conversation in my family.
Every day I read. Every day. There is an whatever you see books here, everything I have read that book. Books I have not yet read, I'll keep it down. Without reading, it's hard for me to sleep. Most of my reading is done when I travel. And I travel 20 days in a month.
Books is something, it's not work for us. You know, it's just a way of being. It's just being able to live every day.
One of the things my mother also used to, you know, expose me to all the time. So all of these elements of appreciation of literature, of history, of culture, our land, our country, all of these elements are very much there in the Murty Classical Library of India.
I started learning writing in English only when I crossed 50. I have 31 books in English now. And I realized the importance of writing in English is within 6 months, my book will be published by 12 different authors in different languages, in many airports. The adults came and told me, our entire generation has been grown up on your books. I feel nice.
Learning is just a part of her being. She's currently also learning ancient Kannada. She's done her detailed study on Sanskrit. She's gone and studied the Bible. She's gone and, you know, studied ancient Vedas. An amazing quality that I've discovered with Mrs. Murty is her interest in wanting to know how the younger generation thinks. What does LOL mean? Or what does FOMO mean? How do you guys think? What is Tinder? And I think that's a beautiful part of her. It's almost childlike.
Gopi is my great source of joy. And I can spend hours together with Gopi, doing no activity at all.
Ever since Gopi's come into her life, he's completely taken over it. He's her fourth baby. So she has Rohan and Akshita, Infosys Foundation, which is her third. And now she has a fourth.
If Gopi is happy, then Amma is happy. If Gopana is happy, Amma is happy.
When Sudha was 17, she wanted to be an engineer. Something girls were not encouraged to be back in those days. But Sudha is stubborn and brave. So she did it. And did it better than all the boys.
See, my father wanted her to become a doctor. She refused. Those days, engineers, lady engineers were very rare. So my father was a little bit worried. Because all boys and only one girl, what she will do in the college, like that, you know.
In 1968, I joined engineering college, and it was very unusual in a place like Hubli. And a girl from a Brahmin middle class community joining engineering college, unheard. And when I went to college, our college professor felt that she will not be able to cope up, she will leave within a year. Don't waste money on building a toilet. A classmate felt there is a new person in the zoo, and they were not used to seeing a lady in engineering college, and they didn't know how to react. There were 150 admission, 149 boys, and I was the only girl. First year was very difficult for me because nobody's talking, nobody gives me notes, nobody smiles at me. And teachers look at me in a very different way that, did you understand? Every time they will tell me. Because boys will understand, but being a girl with a limited knowledge or something, or limited IQ, I don't know what they thought. I stood first to the university. And that time I realized the power, a power of a woman. I could beat all the boys, and I stood first in their own game, which was known as a man's subject. I can make it a woman's subject. And when we started Infosys Foundation, the first thing I said, I realized what it is to be a woman and no toilet, and we built 14,000 toilets. My college gave me a great strength in my life. And that confidence probably has remained with me even up to this date. I'm as enthusiastic, as bold as I was 51 years back. Time has not affected me.
Mrs. Murty does not encourage gifts, but there is one gift that she could not refuse. It was a gift made of love and 3,000 stitches.
All these Devadasis, now retired and rehabilitated, they wanted to celebrate their life. They said, Amma, you have done so much work for us and we humiliated you. We looked down upon you. You used bad words to you. Still you did. And you have changed our life so much. We thought we should give you something.
आगे कोटा बोल के विलेज है उधर हम क्विल्ट कैसा बनाते हैं वो प्रोजेक्ट देख नजर
we decided we'll give you a blanket or a quilt where every one of us will put one stitch for you, making it 3,000 of us will have 3,000 stitches in some design.
Madam, don't, I don't want sari, anything, you don't gift anything. That's why women will marry from cow, make from cowdy. But cowdy, definitely she is using quilting. One, there are some women stitches in her heart.
They're not great artists. And you can see today the kind of quilt they make. It is not just a quilt for me, it is much more than that. Every thread, every needle, every stitch has a story to tell. How these 3,000 women became prostitutes and became normal later. So this is a story of 3,000 stitches. The quilt represent their life, their hopes, and their desire to change. It is a story of 20 years. Selfless work of Abhay, some work of mine, and perseverance. Most importantly, the story of those women who wanted a change and they became the change makers. This story I wanted to share with many people. And every time I can't tell everyone the whole story. So I said, why can't I write? And that became a part of my book. I showed the cover story along with quilt design and some ghungru in that, indicating they were Devdasis. And that is a source of inspiration for me to write 3,000 Stitches book.
Will we ever be able to summarize all of Mrs. Murthy's stories in one book? Probably not. But if we can tell even a few, that's enough to inspire people for generations to come.
Of course, Sudha's mind was always there. She talked about the importance of sharing whatever little we have with the poorest of the poor.
Mrs. Sudha Murty standing by this work for so many years. That is what today shows you results. My advice to most philanthropists would be, do not try to change world in just 1-2 years and with a few lakhs of rupees.
Natvaham kamaye rajyam, na swargam na punarbhavam, kamaye dukhataptanam, praninam artinashanam. Oh God, if you want to give me a rebirth, a kingdom, you know, and some body, I don't need any one of them. If you really insist I should be given something, then give me a kind heart, a compassionate heart, and a strong hand so that I can wipe the tears of others.